Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about the difference between osmolarity and tonicity. Or in simple words, the difference between the suffix osmotic and tonic. So let's get started. The osmolarity is the unit of concentration of a solution. It is expressed as the number of solutes per unit volume of solution. For example, the osmolarity of plasma is about 280 milliosmoles per liter. This means the plasma has that many solutes in 1 liter of water. Now, different solutions can have different osmolarity. If the other solution has the same number of solutes per unit volume as plasma, it's called isosmotic. For example, 5% dextrose. If there are fewer solutes, it's called hypoosmotic. For example, half normal saline. And if it has more solutes, it's called hyperosmotic. In short, the suffix osmotic indicates what is the osmolarity of the other solution as compared to that of plasma. So it depends purely on the number of solutes in a solution. But the term tonicity is totally different thing. In one line, it refers to how a solution affects the cell volume. Hypertonic solution causes the cell to lose water. So, there is shrinking of the cell. A hypotonic solution causes water entry and thereby swelling. And isotonic solution does not produce any effect on the cell volume. These are the literal meanings of these terms. And they have no unit. In short, the suffix tonic describes what a solution would do to a cell volume. Now, in contrast to osmolarity, which depends only on the number of solutes in the solution, the tonicity depends on both the number of solutes as well as whether these solutes can cross the cell membrane or not. To understand why the permeability of the cell membrane is important, we will take examples of normal saline and 5% dextrose. They both have osmolarity of about 280 milliosmoles per liter. And the osmolarity of intracellular fluid is also about the same. Thus, in terms of osmolarity, they both are isosmotic to the cell. Now, when you put a cell in normal saline, there won't be any net movement of water across the cell membrane. That is because the cell membrane is impermeable to sodium and chloride. So there is no change in cell volume. Thus, in terms of tonicity, this solution is isotonic. But the story of 5% dextrose is different. The cell membrane is permeable to the glucose. So if you put a cell in that solution, the glucose enters the cell. This entry causes the water to follow by osmosis. So the cell volume increases. Thus this solution is hypotonic in spite of being isosmotic. Thus isosmotic fluid is not always isotonic. Even hyperosmotic solutions are not always hypertonic. Although hypoosmotic solutions are always hypotonic. But we don't need to go into the details of each and every possibility. Just remember, the osmolarity refers to the concentration of the fluid, and tonicity refers to how the solution affects cell volume. The osmolarity depends only on the number of solutes in unit volume of solution. But for tonicity, whether the solutes can cross the membrane or not also matters. The osmolarity has a unit, but the tonicity has no unit. Now for sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. Earlier we saw that glucose entering the cell drags water along with it osmotically. So the 5% dextrose solution acts as a hypotonic solution. But that is not the whole story. The glucose that enters the cell is eventually metabolized. Thus, in long term, giving 5% dextrose is equivalent to giving pure water to the patient. For this reason, this solution is used in dehydration. Now you might ask, can't we give the pure water right away then? Well, if you do that, there will be a sudden and rapid inflow of water into the red blood cells and other cells near the infusion site. So, they swell and might even burst also. Thus, giving pure water causes hemolysis and other damage. With 5% dextrose, the ultimate result is similar to giving the pure water only. But because of the relatively slower entry of glucose into the cells, this result is achieved more gradually without harmful consequences. That's it for this video. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.